Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Weasel, and today we're going to play The Beginner's Guide. And in case you're wondering, why do I look so weird with my glasses? I'm wearing those as protection because I got LASIK / PRK a few days ago. And yeah, my eyes, they still hurt. And this is not smog or any kind of smoke coming from the side. This is just mist keeping this room nice and humid, just, you know, to be easy on my eyes. In any case, without any further ado, let's go ahead and start the beginner's guide. Let's begin the game. The beginner's guide is a game that was highly recommended to me, and I try to avoid as many spoilers as I can. And it is a very interesting experience. If you haven't heard of the game, you're in for a treat. But I would ultimately recommend you play it yourself before watching this game. And
thank you very much for playing the beginner's
guide.
Here
we go.
My name is Davey Reedon. I wrote The Stanley Parable. And while that game tells a pretty absurd story, today I'm going to tell you about a series of events that happened between 2008 and 2011.
Okay.
We're going to look at the games made by a friend of mine named Coda. Now, these games mean a lot to me. I met Coda in early 2009 at a time when I was really struggling with some personal stuff, and his work pointed me in a very powerful direction. I found it to be a good reference point for the kinds of creative works that I wanted to make. So just to start you off, this is, I think, the first game he ever made.
Oh,
it's a
hi there.
Counter-Strike. You can walk around here, by the way.
Oh, cool.
And mostly it's just Coda learning the basics of building a 3D environment.
Yeah,
but what I like is that even though he starts from the simple aesthetic of a desert town, he then scatters these colorful abstract blobs and impossible floating crates around the level.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, it destroys the illusion that this actually is a desert town, and instead this level becomes a kind of calling card from its creator. It's like a reminder that this video game was constructed by a real person. And it kind of makes you wonder, what was going through his head as he was building this? This is what I like about all of Coda's games. I mean, not that they're all fascinating as games, but that they are all going to give us access to their creator. I want us to see past the games themselves. I want to get to know who this human being really is. And that's exactly what we're going to do here.
That sounds exciting, actually.
It's 2008. Coda starts making these games, and he never releases any of them. He doesn't put them onto the internet. He just makes them and then immediately abandons them, and they sit on his computer forever. And I think he really understood this image of himself as a recluse. At one point, he jokingly renamed his computer's recycling bin to Important Games Folder. So, you know, this was just how he worked. He tended to crank them out one after the other without even really pausing to try to understand what he had just made, until suddenly one day, he just stopped. In 2011, that was it. He made his last game, and then he hasn't made another one since.
Huh, fascinating.
And that's why I've taken this opportunity to gather all of his work together, is because I find his games powerful and interesting, and I'd like this collection to reach him, to maybe encourage him to start creating again. And if the people like you who play this also happen to find his work interesting, then I'm sure it'll just send that much stronger of a message of encouragement to Coda. So thanks for joining me on this. If you have a particular interpretation that I haven't mentioned here, or if you just need to get in touch, you can email me at daveywreden@gmail.com.
I wonder for how many news letters he got signed up.
Let's take a look at Coda's first proper game.
All right,
as each game
now I'm
is
curious.
Living, I'll show you the date that it was completed. This first one was made in November 2008.
All right, that's really exciting. I can't wait to see what Coda came up with. I do like to see the progress, especially that people make. Whisper Machine, what?
Whisper Machine active. Ship destruction
imminent. What? Come again?
This
the
game
Whisper
is
Machine.
Escape from Whisper, and it's one of the more generic games you'll see from Coda.
That's still not bad. Oh my. You know, for the first game. Okay, there.
You can click to fire the gun.
Oh, fantastic. Yeah, we don't need sounds for the gun. That's okay. That's actually, there are sounds.
Security call breached. Hostile alien life form inbound.
Uh-oh. Okay. No enemies yet. I'm just gonna...
It kind of looks like this game was abandoned mid-development.
Yeah,
for instance,
seems like it.
You have this gun, which you'd think would indicate that there are supposed to be monsters or enemies somewhere. But then clearly, there are no enemies anywhere. You can't even reload the gun when you run out of bullets.
Oh, no.
But ultimately, we don't really know. Maybe Coda thought that actually it was complete the way that it is. And I think that we should talk about his games for what they are, rather than for what they're not.
Okay, you got me intrigued. Oh, we're gonna keep going. Very nice. Whisper, evacuate immediately.
I love how you can see the bottom of the universe from this room.
That's still cool. I wouldn't have noticed necessarily if I would just kept walking and not, looked over. Okay. It's a skybox. It's an actual box. You know, that's why they call it skybox. Okay, then. I kind of feel like a jump scare is imminent.
The space station has a labyrinth on it.
Definitely.
I don't know. There's really no reason for it that I've ever been able to discern, so in the interest of time, I'm just going to skip you on past it.
Well, thank you. That's very nice.
Okay, this is the part that's interesting. The game has this narrative about the Whisper Machine and how it has to be turned off, and then you get to the engine room.
Ooh, fancy.
Hey, you there, in the engine room. You could save us all. That beam is powering the Whisper Machine. We could disrupt it by introducing a great enough heat signature. If you... your body could stop the beam. It's so much to ask, but for all of our lives, would you do it? Could you give yourself?
Oh, wow. That's you know, you're asking me, of a pretty big sacrifice, but I guess given that I'm the hero, yeah. Might as well. Pretty good voice acting. I wonder if that's the original one.
Let me pause here for a second. What you just experienced, stepping into the beam and then dying, is probably what Coda had initially intended when he was developing this level. But when he first compiles and plays it, something goes wrong. There's a bug somewhere. And this is what happens instead.
Okay, what happens? Oh my. Wait, this is pretty cool, actually.
The beam causes you to start floating.
Deep?
And this is an important moment for him. Because yes, this is technically a glitch, but Coda identifies something human about it. Like how small it makes you feel in the face of this larger chaotic system. Or this floating could be the afterlife, a peaceful place, juxtaposed against all of the hysteria that you've just had to traverse. I don't even know. I have no idea what he was thinking, but... what's clear is that after making this, something lodges itself in his brain. He wants to do more of these really weird and experimental designs. So he stops work on this and moves on to a stream of tiny little games that go in all sorts of directions.
Ooh,
let's go
exciting.
Ahead and take a look at the first game he made after leaving this one behind.
All right, November 2008. If it wasn't for the the past was behind
in
her.
In this game, you can only walk backwards.
Oh, okay. This is actually pretty interesting. And a little bit disorienting. Wait, what?
So it's a short and relatively minimalist experiment combining motion and narrative. It is less advanced than the previous game, but actually it seems to be more focused, more complete. Coda is trying to give it a unique voice rather than simply basing it on a pre-existing trope.
When she stops and looks, it becomes clearer. I wish I could walk forward. This is really, but the future is always behind her. How will she find the strength to confront it?
It's a short little thought. It says what it wants to say.
Still.
And it ends. Didn't need anything more than that. Which
yeah, that's
me,
very compact.
It works because it gets out quick. Okay, next one.
Oh my. Please, no scary game. Okay, yeah, we can see a whole lot. We got like a really mean fog. You're now entering. What am I entering? Yes.
And that's it. Okay,
what?
The meaning of this game won't be clear just yet. Please be patient with me for a few more games, and I promise you'll see what makes it interesting.
Okay, I believe you.
Oftentimes, Coda would put bizarre titles like this one at the start of his games.
Oh my. Well, Coda.
I wish I'd known him at the time that he was making these early games. He would really only talk to me about his work as he was making it. Once he stopped work on a game, like, that was it. It was dead to him. And I don't agree with that at all, but what are you gonna do?
I mean, oh my. Yeah, we're getting slower and slower. Can I walk back? Oh.
Once you've been slowed to an absolute crawl, the door at the top of the stairs opens. So why, if Coda's not showing these games to anyone, why bother opening the door at all? Well, to show you, I'm modifying the game here so that when you press enter, it'll bring you back up to full speed so you can enter the door for yourself.
Okay, let's go up to full speed and see. That's very interesting. I like these elements. Hello. Come again? Okay, a stranger appears. You start, the game is nothing but giant blocks of text explaining what's happening. Stand on an egg staring at a beer for 3 hours.
And nice and filled with little ideas for games.
Aww. Yeah, that's what they are.
Coda would often tell me that he didn't mind if people thought of him as cold or distant. He said that he knew that he was actually a vibrant and compassionate person, but that it takes time to really see that. It can be a very slow climb to get there.
Talk about deep, man. A key in one game unlocks a door in a completely separate game. Huh. Stand on X staring at a bear. You must... Oh. Okay. Ready, set, fish. Sounds like an interesting little mobile casual game title, doesn't it? Yes, Wheatley. I know, I'm excited. I want to know what comes next. Hi. I wonder if you made them all in the Source engine. Because, you know, they've been clearly ported over into Unity, I think. At least I think it feels like Unity. Might be Source engine. Honestly, I have no idea what this game was made in. Would make sense if it's in the...
Well, this is new for Coda.
Source
engine.
It's an
actual puzzle. Go ahead and see if you can solve it.
Okay. Let's press the thing to see what happens first. I mean... Okay. Let's just walk in. What's the worst that could happen to us? Just walking to the sides here to see if something's hidden in the darkness. Does it have anything to do with the game we saw you are now entering? Okay, I'll lock myself in. Oh! There's another switch now at this door.
Don't forget that solution, because we're going to see this puzzle again soon.
Okay.
We're gonna see it a lot.
I like it. I like it. I have no idea what these three holes are about. Okay, there's just three black dots. There might not even be holes in there. Yeah, it looks very familiar. I'll try to not forget this puzzle.
So that seems to be it, right?
Yeah.
You walk down a corridor, you solve the puzzle, you get to the end. Simple enough. All right.
Pretty much.
Now I'm going to modify the game again so that when you press enter, it'll remove all of the walls from this room.
What? In the name of what? What? Are you for real?
How about that? There was more to it than we had any way of knowing. I actually find it funny that this game comes after the stairs game, since they essentially convey the opposite idea. So, in the stairs game, a dull exterior conceals... a rich interior. And then, in this level, a dull interior hides this fantastic outer world. Either way, I think that the point is the same, is that most of the time you don't get to know what you're missing, or even that you're missing anything. That's not your role as a player. So if your role here is not to understand, then what is it?
That's a really good question, and I have no idea whatsoever. Okay, so we're back at this game that he said, remember this, this is gonna come in handy later.
So, this, combined with the entering game from earlier, tells us that Coda believes his games are connected somehow.
Oh.
It could even be that the stairs game and the puzzle game are literally connected in between this and the entering game. There's a bigger picture that all of his games are meant to play a role in, some larger meaning that we won't be able to grasp until we've seen all of them. And once we have, we can step back and start to understand what exactly that bigger picture is.
Okay. I do like the idea. I'm just fascinated by the fact that he'd never shown this to anyone. I mean, you know, to him he has shown it at least, or at least he must have had his hands on that, but still. So there's so much work and just, you know, putting it in his recycle bin.
Let's talk about video game development for a second.
Okay,
every
sure.
video game runs on what's called an engine, which determines what the game can and cannot do.
Mm-hmm.
So in other words, the engine is a set of tools for game development.
Sure thing.
To make all of these games, Coda is using an engine called Source.
Like I assume engines, this is also Source.
Source has certain things that it does well, and it has certain things that it does poorly. One of the things that it does very well is boxy linear corridors. That's why so many of Coda's games are set in these large, flat, empty rooms, is just because he's working with what the engine does well.
Hi. What's going on here?
The tools available to the creator shape what kinds of creative work they're going to end up making. You might consider paying attention to the architecture in Coda's games, to notice
like
how they seem to stem from an engine that's very good at producing linear, boxy corridors.
Okay, yeah, I can believe that. I'm just gonna jump down here. It'll be fine. And I survived. Good. I'm just gonna make my way all the way down. This is a very odd experience. I hope I have to go down, otherwise I will definitely be stuck here. Yep. Does it just keep going or... Ah! There is something at the bottom. Oh, no! Okay, we're fine. I didn't have to jump on the individual blocks. Oh, my. Hi, there. Very ominous. And another underground hallway waiting for us. This creeps me out a little bit. Can't help it. Ugh. Okay. What is this? I mean, it does look like a prison. Oh. Okay. And here we go. Are you putting me in the prison cell now? If so, I'm not cool with that.
This prison,
yep.
Funny enough, in Coda's original design, the door stayed shut for a full hour before
really?
Letting you go. If you don't mind, I think we're gonna skip that.
Thank you. That's very,
this is something that he and
nice.
I used to argue about a lot. You know, whether a game ought to actually be playable, whether it means anything if no one can get through it. And I would always defend that, you know, all this work goes into the game, why not make it playable and accessible? And so we just got into heated arguments over it, and there was one time that after one of these conversations, he went home, and a day or two later, he sent me a zip file entitled Playable Games that was full of hundreds of individual games.
Wow.
Each of which was just an empty box that you walked around in and nothing else. Believe me, I played every single one of those just to find out if there was like a gag hidden somewhere. There wasn't.
I mean, the whole thing itself was a gag, wasn't it? But he's right. You technically have a playable game at that point. Then again, without a conflict, I don't know if you could still consider it a game. I have some, you know, definitions and, you know, you could argue about
it's the
know,
puzzle
what
again,
makes a game.
With the exact same solution as the last time.
Okay, that I can... I'm not too concerned about that then. Ugh. Black fog is kind of weird, isn't it? Thank you.
There's still no clear indication of what makes this puzzle so special that Coda is going to return to it over and over. But I promise, I'll share with you my interpretation very shortly.
I am intrigued. I would love to know what your interpretation of that is. For me, right now I have none. This is an interesting puzzle, and I'm gonna use it again, but, you know. Okay. Hi, guys. No! This weirds me out, but sure. Hi. You there, did you come from above? What
here,
was up
Coda
there?
Coda begins using a kind of dialogue system that he fashioned out of the engine's chat capabilities. Use the 1, 2, 3 buttons on your keyboard to respond.
Alright, you there, did you come from above? What was up there? Yes, there was a world stamped with whiteness. Yes, there was an enormous prison I spent hours in. Yes, there were floating colored blocks. Sure, there were blocks. Colored floating blocks. That's the world above, you've been there. Now, this is important. Did you have to get through a puzzle with 2 doors and switches? Yes, I did. This was literally the last thing I did before coming here. Yeah, sure. Yes, I did. Again, perfect. Now, please tell us how you solved it. Tell us the solution. Tell us how to get to the other side. I didn't solve it. Someone else let me in. Trust me, you don't want to go out there. I don't remember how I solved it. I'm trying to remember, but I can't. I mean, I did solve it. Trust me, you don't want to go over there. I don't know how I would solve it from this side, so... Trust me, you don't want to go over there. Why not? Oh no, but I do. We do. We need to get over there. Do you understand? It's the most important thing in the world. I like that this guy says speak. We must have to escape this prison. There must be an ending, I promise you. Damn it, I missed that. Well then, that was nice to meet you. I'm gonna, you know, just leave. Thanks very much. Oh, it's you again. Hi, guys. How'd you get there? Was a puzzle you had to pass through. Wait, oh, you're giving me another chance? Yes, do you want to know how to solve it? Sure. Maybe I know this time. No, no, we actually find the black space between the doors to be far more interesting. Have you seen it yet? Now that you mention it, I remember feeling strange as I passed through it. I don't recall a space between the doors. I'm gonna say I feel strange passing through it. Don't think too hard about it. You'll see it again soon. Maybe we can explore it the next time. And have a closer look, but yeah. Can I have a look here for the- Yep. Nope, can't get up there, but there's books. Why are there books up there? I wonder. Little fireplace. Nice little detail. And down we go. Well, hello.
And so we make one last descent down to the final floor of the level.
Yes. Oh. This looks like a neighborhood. Am I seeing that correctly? Yeah, like an apartment complex or, you know, hotel rooms.
It's a lamppost.
Well,
okay,
yes.
I can't tell you quite why, but for some reason, Coda fixates on this lamppost. It's going to appear at the end of every single one of his games from here on out. I'll tell you what I think. I think that up to this point, you know, he's been making really strange and abstract games with no clear purpose, and maybe you can only float around in that headspace for so long. Because now he wants something to hold on to. He wants a reference point. He wants the work to be leading to something. He wants a destination, which is what this lamppost is. It's a destination.
I can see that.
We're going to see it in the work as well. His games are just
going to become
guides
a lot
more cohesive, a lot more fully developed, with more of a clear idea behind them. And as we go, that idea will get clearer and clearer and clearer.
Well, I'm excited to see where he's going with that. Okay. Next game is from... April 2009. That's a while ago, isn't it? As you walk around, you can leave notes. All notes you see are left by other players. Really? Is that possible? Hi. I can't see... Was it with enter? Oh, there it is. It was nice room.
I'm sure you can deduce this, but this game is not connected to the internet. All of the notes that you're going to see have been written by Coda. This was actually the first game of his that I ever played. This was shortly after I met him at a weekend game jam in Sacramento, where I grew up. I saw him working on this very level, and it was just so different from anything that anyone else was doing. So right away I was like, I have to be friends with this person. In retrospect, I think I was probably a bit too pushy trying to get his attention. I was
okay.
Overenthusiastic.
That's
but
fine.
But he was very gracious about it and very patient with me. and I cooled off eventually.
No point, just I'm guilty of those things too. That can happen when you're like really excited, you know, about someone and you just yeah, you're a little, I guess pushy is the right word. Whoa, holy shit. It would be interesting if you could actually leave notes, but man, wouldn't that be full? Can you guys hear me? No, I cannot. Hello? Reasonable.
Okay, feel free to skip over any of these notes if they're not doing anything for you. Nothing extra is going to happen if you read all of them.
All right, everyone
Either
read
way,
this.
To me, they convey a sense of loneliness. I see this person who's filled with thoughts and feelings and beliefs and has no way to express them except as scattered and unheard voices in a game that wasn't meant to be played.
Hmm. Hey, I can type here. Yes, you can.
But it's
Why?
Ironic, isn't it, that in playing this game and seeing how alone Coda often felt, that we get to know him better and actually kind of connect with him. And I have to be honest with you, this idea is really seductive to me. That I could just play someone's game and see the voices in their head and get to know them better and have to do less of the messy in-person socializing. I could just get to know
How do they get to know you work. Then? How do they get to
I
know
think
you?
This is why I always liked Coda's games so much, is because it felt like they let me have that connection. I felt as though he was inviting me personally into his world. And then I feel less lonely too.
What the shit is this cavern? I can assure you guaranteed that there's an acorn somewhere here in this place, and the sailors are looking for it. Come again, Coda. Hey guys, just looking for someone to talk with. Aww, that is adorable. I refuse to believe. No, believe. You better believe. Butt as butt! I was wondering where that would be. I wouldn't have believed that it was connected to the internet without any of that. I need to go to the freaking bathroom. Well, and, you know, nobody's stopping you. Recognize me, please. Notice me, senpai. There's nothing here. Go back. Don't listen to that guy. And this is, I guess, the end. A free t-shirt. Makes games, includes door, cannot open door. Thanks. Need other side. Door, why you so? Door, how open? Open sesame. That's a cute idea. Someday I will meet the person who made this. Maybe I will. Who knows? I help people because of the internal good feeling I get. New room. Ooh, fancy picture over there. Do you hear the chimes? They keep you going, don't they? I don't hear chimes. I would like very much to be desired. It's weird when you think that these are all thoughts from one person. Welcome, congratulations. I don't really know where to go with this. I wonder if you were thinking that when you're making the game. I am compelled to do what? Stop, turn back, proceeding further will only result in misery. I am willing to take that risk. Cabbage shapes our nation. Absolutely, we're a cabbage nation. Hey, don't talk about me that way. I don't think this is going anywhere. I'm willing to bet it is. I need someone to talk to. Aw. This is a note? Don't listen to the other notes. I like the lighting here on the side. The subtle lighting. I'm not safe. Okay, then. Okay, let's listen to the comments to this picture. Painting, what does it mean? Does it need to mean something? Whoever made this has issues. He probably has, but so has everyone. I'm trying to speak. Okay. I'm hearing actually voices. Very, 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 very subtle. Devil Tower Star. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's keep going. See where this is heading. Well, I'm here now. Yeah, we're all here now. So sassy. There must be a reason for it, though. What could it be? His terrible secret. He kept it well. I beat the game. No, you did not. Liar. More room?
At the end of this level, we're going to see the puzzle again. And here, I'll tell you what I think the puzzle means. Each of these games represents an idea that was on Coda's mind at the time that he was making it. And the puzzle is a way of closing the door on a previous chapter of his life before moving on to the next one.
Become one with the spiraling nonsense. Okay, now you can hear the voices too. And there's the black dots again. There are the three black dots. What do they mean? Downward, keep digging.
In each of his games, after exploring a theme that, you know, he might find difficult, Coda can then place this puzzle that he knows has a reliable solution, he understands exactly how it works, and so it gives him a simple mechanism for moving on.
Here's my question though, did he add all of these sounds to it? Or were the sounds of the music added afterwards? Because they feel really high quality. Does this puzzle have a solution? Literally an hour, what the fuck do I do? Well, I know what to do.
And because there's this dark area between the doors, a space between spaces, before you move on, you get to pause. Just for a moment, a few seconds to reflect on and let go of the events that led you here. To step back and connect the pieces together. To grasp at that elusive bigger picture.
Okay, the voices are still there. And they kind of freak me out. Oh, it's typing. Okay, it's a typewriter. Less freaky, still weird. How do you leave notes? Huh. Hi. Okay. Are you there? Please say something. It can't be anything. I just need you to say something. Talk to me, please. Why are you having so much difficulty talking? Speak. Ooh. Okay. I'm getting goosebumps here. May to June 2009. Porn stars die
this
too.
This one is tough. It's gonna kind of just spin its own wheels for a few minutes. Hang with it.
Okay, sure. Just a random picture of some city street. Okay. Walk-in closet. What do we have here? I see part of the world, I guess. And, well. Sure, I'll hang with it. I'm now very intrigued in what's going on. In Coda's mind. I do wonder about the music, though. It didn't mention anything if the music was added afterwards. I kind of feel that music was added afterwards. But who knows? Oh, it's
see, like,
the well.
This is it. The whole game. And there's nothing that's particularly interesting about it. You just walk to the end of a hallway. Except, for some reason, Coda gets really fixated on this prison that has all of this modern furniture. And I don't know why, but he decides he needs to revisit this prison. He's gonna start over, use the same assets, turn it into something else. Okay, cool. Here's version 2.
Oh my, okay, so now there's just blocks? What furniture ought to go in the center of the room? How about a TV for surround sound? Put a giant hole in the ground. That I like. That's not a giant hole. Lies! Okay, now what about along the wall of the room? Let's put a huge picture of a horse. I like that. Nope, it's a couch. What is... See, you're not listening. I think we should light up this room a bit. Well, let's put live Tesla coils in each corner. Yeah. Well, was worth a try. And a table. Do you need a table? We do have you. Where are you? Where exactly are you doing this from? I'm pretty sure none of my choices make any difference. Yep. Wow. Okay. Hi.
There's a bit more to this one, but still, it's not really communicating anything. It's kind of just weird for weirdness's sake.
Yeah, I would agree.
So, okay, he throws it out and starts over. This time he comes at the prison idea from a different direction.
I like the iteration, though. Hello, please walk forward. Sure, this guide will enable you to escape. Follow the instructions carefully. Take care that you remember each step. First, click on this table. Good, now go over to the photo frame and click to turn it slightly. There's the three dots again. Okay. What next? Now turn the floor lamp in this room off, then turn it back on. Okay, what next? Oh, right, turn it back on. Now go to the left side sofa, move it over a little. Finally, touch the shelves. That's it. In a real prison, the escape will now open. Return to the star to be taken back to your prison. Okay. Yeah, these games are certainly connected. Return. But why are these worlds connected?
And of course, now the table is gone and you can't begin the chain of events to escape.
Oh.
Here's a version where there are no bars, but you can't actually get to the well. And then a version where the inside of the prison is the outside and the outside is the inside. Let me just blink you real quick through a few more of these. I mean, he really unloaded on this prison idea. There's nearly a dozen of them. Personally, I think it's awful to watch this. To see a person basically unraveling through their work. And for what? Like, at what point do you just go, maybe there are game ideas other than this prison that I could be working on? But Coda doesn't have that voice telling you to stop. That particular mechanism of defense against yourself. Without it, you just spiral. And so he keeps going and going and going and going and going. And then he hits on something.
Oh my, and he lights please.
It. And that's it. He's done. He stops making prisons. This is the very last version of the prison game that he created. And the reason I think it works is that the prison is not actually in it.
Okay. A little creepy, but... Wait, so this is the version... How is this a version of the prison level if there's no prison in it? I mean, maybe he named it after that. Got a... Phone booth, I want to say. And a lamppost. I mean, the lamppost being the end. Hello. I don't like it. I don't like the creepy sounds. Hello, who is this? Hey, it's me. I'm you from after you escaped from prison. You're me? So you were trapped in this prison too? Yep, I was in the furniture maze. I was in the escape tutorial.
And so this is what Coda wants, is to be able to talk to someone, to share what's on his mind, and to get some good advice from someone who knows.
Yep, I was in the furniture maze.
Even in this scenario, you're still talking to yourself. You know, all of these games so far are Coda talking to himself.
Actually, I'm already forgetting what being in the prison was like. I guess, yeah. What's it like to escape? Really, how long has it been since you got out? Oh, years. Like, I've been standing right here working up the nerve to call you. Only a few minutes, but somewhat already fuzzy, kind of like it never happened. Let's go with that. But this is the worst, most desperate thing I've ever been through. How could you possibly forget it? I promise you, it's not as bad right now as you think it is. You don't ever forget it, you just stop identifying with it. Anything can seem infinite when you're drenched in it. Let's go with that one. Wait, if you're me, then did you get a call from another version of you when you were trapped? No, I think I'm the first person to call back. I think so, at least. I don't remember getting a call at all. Then can you tell me how to get out? Maybe I can find you. What do I have to do? To get out, all you have to do is be sincere. To get out, you need to tell me how you feel right now. To get out, just talk with me a bit. Alright, tell me how you feel right now. What? That will free me? How does that work? Listen, you can't know until you're out, but I promise it works. Just tell me how you feel, it will make sense. Let's go if it will make sense. Okay, I feel afraid that nothing will ever change. Go on. And that's it, I guess.
I can see why he considers this a fitting conclusion to the prison games. After all of the obsession and frustration, just to be told by someone you can trust that things are going to be okay, wouldn't that be nice?
Oh, definitely.
So what would it look like if Coda wanted to make a game about talking to someone other than himself?
That's a good question. I think we're going to figure that out in the next episode. Thank you guys so much for watching the Beginner's Guide. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please leave a like, and I hope to see you guys in the next episode. I'm Weasel. I'm out, and I hope to see you around. Bye-bye.